A very good morning to all my students. I hope you all are fine. Let's begin with our maths class. In maths, what we are going to do today is something very interesting, really very interesting. Why is it so? Because we will be learning how to choose the correct option given to us. That means we are already given with the solutions, we are already given with the answers, and there are a choice between them. We do have many choices to make. Like, see, every question has one solution, but here for one question I'm given with many options. I'm given with three options, and out of these three only one is correct. So I need to choose which one is correct. Choose the correct option means we need to find the correct answer. So let's begin with this. How we do this? We call it multiple choice questions also. Multiple means more than one, means many. So whenever we are given with many options, ek hi question ke agar hame bahut sare options diye jate hain, usse hum multiple choice question bolte hain. This is in EVS, in English, in Hindi, in Maths, in any of the subject we can have this. Hame ek hi solution find out karna hota hai, that one should be the correct one. To us correct ko dhoondna hai, we will be doing the multiplication, the addition, the subtraction, whatever in mind, and will find out which is the correct right answer, and then we will find out. So what we are given with here is, let's read first one, 5 plus 0. 5 plus 0 means we need to add 5 and 0. I am also given with option, in A part it is written 5 and then there is a box. In B part it is written 0, again there is a box. And in C part it is 6, again there is a box. What I need to do is, I will be calculating in my mind what 5 plus 0 comes out to be. And out of these three, whatever my answer will be, I will put a tick mark in that box. In one box only. Which one is correct? So I need to put only one tick in that, against that number only. So as we have already done, zero means nothing. Whenever I'm not adding anything to any number, so the number will remain same. I'm not adding anything to 5, so 5 will remain as it is. 5 plus 0 will give me 5. 5 plus 0 will give me 5. So where is the 5 written? In the option A. In the option A it is written 5. That means my option A is correct. That means my option A is correct. So whatever the option is correct, I will put a tick there in that box. In that box. You can see the other two boxes, I have not filled anything. No need to put cross there. No need to write anything there. Just put a tick against that number only. Alright, let's do the second one now. 8 minus 8. When we are subtracting, minus means subtraction. And when we are subtracting, the same numbers are written there. You do have 8 toys. And you give all those 8 toys to your sister or your brother. Then how many toys will be left with you? No toy. Because you have given all of the 8 toys to that person. So once we are having the same numbers together, my answer becomes 0. My answer becomes 0. So where is 0 written? In A option it is written 1. In option B it is written 8. And in C option it is written 0. As I have told you, 0 is the correct answer. So I will put a tick here. I will put a tick here. As I have put the dashes here, you can also write the correct answer in dashes also if you want so. But it is not needed. It is not much needed. The main thing is when you are choosing, choose the correct option is given to you. When you are choosing, you need to put the tick against the correct option. So we have done the two questions. In the first one, A, correct option, the answer is 5. In the second question, 8 minus 8, C part is the correct option, that means 0 is the correct answer. So I have put a tick against C part. Let's begin with the third question. Here is written 4 cross 2. 4 cross 2 means I need to think in my mind 4 times 2 means I can think of the table of 4 till 2 or I can think of the table of 2 till 4. Whatever is easier for you, you can go for that. If you find it like 4 times 2, it is 8. It is 8. So, I am given with the option 2, 8 and 6. As I have told you, 8 is the correct answer. So, I will choose the B part as my answer and will also write my answer here. So, in the third question, 4 cross 2 means 4 twos are, that is the answer 8, which I have chosen. Let's do the fourth one now. In the fourth question, it is written 4 plus 3. 4 plus 3, this will be as the simple addition. We will keep 4 in mind and 3 fingers up. 4 in mind and 3 fingers up. After 4, we will start counting. 5, 6, 7. 5, 6, 7. So, my correct answer is 7. A part, the correct option written here is 6. In the B part, option written is 7. And in the C part, it is written 8. My correct answer is 7. So, I will be choosing B part. We have done till question 4. And as you can see, I am ticking against only the correct option. This is the way, my dear students, to choose the correct option. Whenever you are given with options, we are choosing the correct one. That means our correct answer. But we need not to put any crosses or anything. Need not to draw anything in these boxes. Need not to write anything. We are just simply putting the tick against the correct option. Alright? Let's begin. On the next one, we will move. Number 5. I have written the number here 1717. Then there is a dash. After that dash, I have written 1919. Now what to do? Here in the bracket is written what comes between. What comes between? Between which? Between 17 and 19. Think of the number which comes between 17 and 19. It is simple counting. Yes, 18 comes between 17, 18, 19. This is the way we do counting. So, 18 comes between 17 and 19. And let's find where is 18 written in the options. The first option is written with 15. In the B option, it is written 16. And in the C option, it is written 18. So, C option is correct. And we will put a tick here. C option is correct. Let's do the next one, number 6. Number 6 is put the sign. Put the sign, we are given with 3 signs here. This is of greater than, smaller than, and this is of equals to. Whenever we compare 2 or more numbers, then we use such type of signs to show which number is greater and which number is smaller. And how do we compare which number is smaller, which number is greater? The number which comes in counting first, that is considered to be the smaller. If I speak the counting like 41, 42, 43. So, if I talk about 41 and 43, which one is smaller? I have spoken 41 first, then it is smaller. And 43 comes later in counting, that is bigger or greater, you can say. So, here in the A part, two numbers are written 78, 80. 78 comes first in the counting. So, what do you think? 78 is smaller or bigger? This is smaller. And whenever we are presenting this symbol, this is a kind of something just like what I need to teach my students is this is a crocodile with an open mouth and the mouth will be open towards the greatest number or the greater number. That means jo cheez jitni big hai, koi bhi animal agar usko grab karne wala hai, ek big cheez rakhi hai uske samne, koi big thing ya big person ya ek small, to kis ki taraf attract hoga? Towards the big thing. To mouth khula, fish ka ya crocodile ka, whatever you want to suppose, you can suppose. To wo bada muh, khula hua muh kis ki taraf jane wala hai? Bade number ki taraf. And which is bigger here? 80. 78 and 80, which one is bigger? 80. So we will make the sign like this. In the B part, the number is written 12, 9. Here are two digits, 1, 2. And here is only one digit. Which one will be smaller? Let's count. You can count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 this way also. Which comes earlier in counting? That is 9. So what do you think? 9 is greater or smaller? 9 is smaller. And as I have told you, bigger number ki taraf humne iska face, iska mouth open karke banana hai. So this will be the way to represent which number is greater. Which number is greater. So this is how we choose the correct option, how we do these questions which are given to us. I hope aap sabko bahut easy aur interesting bhi lage honge. I find them very interesting to do kyunki maths is one of my favorite subjects all time. And maths mein jab hum calculations karte hain and you are given with options, basically it makes your work more easy also. आप जल्दी से माइंड में क्विकली अपने कैलकुलेशंस करने के बाद यू कैन चूज द करेक्ट ऑप्शन, करेक्ट आंसर. सो जस्ट प्रैक्टिस लाइक दिस ओनली. यू कैन प्रैक्टिस इन एनी ऑफ योर रफ नोटबुक और एनी ऑफ योर प्रैक्टिस नोटबुक. एंड आई होप यू लाइक दिस वीडियो एंड यू आर क्लियर विद द कंसेप्ट. हैव अ गुड डे स्टूडेंट्स.